First word that something was seriously wrong came from this power plant in eastern Sweden, where workers coming on the job registered abnormally high levels of radiation on their bodies.
Attention, a person in Florida has died after being infected with a rare brain-eating amoeba.
The zombie deer disease has returned.
A disease that impacts just one in 1 million people.
There are many things on this earth that people classify as scary. Animals like spiders and snakes. Man-made things like nuclear and chemical weapons. All things people around the world are scared of, and understandably so. These things can kill you. And once most of these are set out to kill, it can be difficult to avoid. Though what makes these things dangerous? A snake sinking its fangs into your flesh isn't pleasant, but it's the two small drops of liquid the snake releases that can kill you in minutes. And the initial blast of a nuclear weapon is deadly, but the countless amount of radiation particles that occur after are what kills in mass. The physical appearance of a spider may be scary, but the true terror lies beyond what the eye can see.
Meaning that whatever did occur there, a radioactive...
Over time, over a year or two, developed...
...is a rare brain disorder.
C specialist at Vanderbilt, Dr. William Schaffner, did not work on Tony's case, but says
This is a very tragic disease because there is no treatment.
Prions are misfolded proteins that can trigger other proteins to fold abnormally, and while that doesn't sound bad, the effects of these misfoldings are absolutely terrifying. To put into perspective, if you caught a severe infection like tuberculosis, you would likely experience symptoms like a terrible cough, a fever, and even blood in your mucus, which upon noticing will likely prompt you to seek medical attention, where you will be treated with antibiotics and generally have a good chance of surviving. Even if left untreated, there's around a 50% chance of death, which isn't great. But if you're infected by or even inherited a prion disease, once symptoms appear, you'd likely be dead within a year. They have no known treatment and are described as 100% fatal or terminal illnesses. Luckily, they are rare, affecting about 1 in 1 million people globally. Though even the small chance of catching it is terrifying. The most common form of prion disease in humans is Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, a degenerative brain disorder which happens for no apparent reason. Not to be confused with variant Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, or more commonly known as mad cow disease. The difference between them is how they occur. Variant CJD most often occurs when the meat of an infected cow is eaten, specifically the nerve tissues. Though blood transfusions with the carrier of the disease are also suspected to cause it. The symptoms of Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease are terrifying. To put a basic, broad label on it, it's basically a much faster version of Alzheimer's. Though this only holds true when symptoms appear, as someone can have CJD for years and have absolutely no symptoms. Early symptoms include personality changes, memory loss, impaired thinking, blurry vision or blindness, insomnia, problems of coordination, trouble speaking, trouble swallowing, and sudden, jerky movements, according to Mayo Clinic. Symptoms often worsen rapidly once they appear. People who have family members with the disease describe as extremely cruel. They often talk about the rapid cognitive decline of those who suffered from it, from being perfectly fine 1 week to being in a coma weeks later, even from being perfectly fine 1 hour to extreme memory loss only hours later. Another prion disease that affects humans is fatal insomnia, that has two main variants, familial and sporadic. The name speaks for itself, as a unique symptom of this prion disease is trouble or an inability to sleep. Since it's a prion disease, most of its qualities are very similar to CJD, aside from two main things. Fatal insomnia mainly affects the part of the brain that controls sleep, the thalamus, and the symptoms of fatal insomnia often worsen more gradually as compared to CJD. Aside from that, the mental decline in stages largely remain the same in humans. In animals, prion disease is much more common, the most common of which, at least in North America, is CWD, or chronic wasting disease, a prion disease that affects deer and other members of the deer family. It spreads through bodily fluids, and is just as cruel as prion diseases in humans. The strangest and most evident symptom of the disease to humans is aimlessly walking in circles for random bouts of time. Deer in later stages of the disease practically turn into zombies, displaying little control over their actions. It can be brought on by mistake or intentionally. Either way, the results are terrible. The initial blast is catastrophic, even in smaller incidents, destroying everything in its path. But that's a small part of what makes nuclear blasts so devastating. During the Chernobyl meltdown, enough pressure is created from the nuclear fumes to blow a 1,000 metric ton lid into the air. A ridiculous amount of radiation was released, 400 times more than in the bombing of Hiroshima. 2 people died from the blast. 26 died from the acute radiation poisoning in the following months. Thousands of people's health who were in the area were also affected by the radiation. Death by radiation is one of the most grueling ways to go, as it's often a slow, yet consistently worsening process. Radiation in large amounts destroys tissue, and more importantly, DNA structures. Which is why people who are exposed to large amounts of radiation initially look fine, and symptoms in the start can appear to improve. Body tissue is constantly dying and being replaced, so by destroying the necessary components for a cell to function properly, things start to die. Blood cell quantity drops, cuts and tears in the skin don't repair, and often worsen. Organs eventually begin to fail, and the victim essentially starts to rot while they're still alive, as can be seen in most of the cases of high radiation exposure. The most well-known of which being one of the victims of the Tokimura nuclear accidents, Hisashi Auchi, who's often referred to as the most radioactive man ever. Though, this is untrue, as there are multiple people who have received higher doses of radiation, the most radioactive of which being Robert Peabody, which was tragically caused by a fallen label, but was exposed to be a degreasing, non-criticality-causing substance called trichlorethine, was actually a uranium solution. He poured this into a tank of uranium-235, which caused it to go critical. This released an enormous amount of radiation. The amount Peabody received was similarly enormous. To put it into perspective, Hisashi Auchi, a man who showed up to the hospital with little to no white blood cells in his blood, severe damage to multiple organs, and a non-functioning immune system, received 17 sieverts of radiation, roughly triple the median lethal dose. Robert Peabody, in a very short amount of time, received 100 sieverts of radiation. He died 49 hours after the incident. Despite the enormous amount of radiation Robert Peabody received, anybody who receives a lethal dose of radiation is subjected to an indescribably awful time. That is part of the reason why what happened to Hisashi Auchi is much more well known than what happened to those who received more radiation than him.
It's the type of shocking news that gets everybody's attention. A person in Florida has died after being infected with a rare brain-eating amoeba.
It happened after the victim was apparently using tap water for a sinus rinse.
Naegleria fowleri, commonly referred to as the brain-eating amoeba, is a microorganism that lives in soil in multiple areas of warm freshwater. It can very rarely live in tap water as well. It enters the body when infected water goes deep into the nose and eventually goes into the brain. It's very rare, but incredibly dangerous if it is caught. It causes destruction on a cellular level, destroying and feasting on neurons that come in its path. In the wild, it typically feasts on bacteria, but it is disturbingly adaptable to the human body. It also feeds off red blood cells through a process called phagocytosis, where the amoeba encloses and digests a cell. The amoeba also develops these things called amoebastomes, which are suckers or mouths on its body that consumes food. What makes the amoeba even more terrifying is how the body responds to it. The immune system does a mostly good job while the amoeba travels to the brain, destroying it one at a time. But once it reaches the brain, the immune system begins to hurt the brain in its path to killing the amoeba. Though once the brain is reached, it's often too late. The amoeba reproduces beyond what the immune system can handle, and slowly eats away at the brain, which is why a major headache, an altered mental state, and often eventually a coma accompanies it. A fever typically accompanies the infection in an attempt to fight off the amoeba, but unfortunately, Naegleria fowleri thrives in high temperatures. The mortality rate is 98.5%, and some survivors have permanent brain damage. The true terror often lies in what microscopic organisms can cause, but they can sometimes be visually terrifying as well. The truth is, the scariest things you can experience are often beyond what the eye can see.